As part of its commitment to CBBG, Arizona State University constructed a field station on its Polytechnic campus to house three systems integration test beds. One test bed is a large, approximately 2,400 cubic feet test pit, where we recently constructed seven field scale biocemented columns using EICP. Here we show exhumation of the columns using a vacuum excavator. Note that our ASU crew assisting with column measurements and excavation is in full COVID health and safety gear. These measurements were performed less than 2 months ago. Measurements included column dimensions, geophysical measurements like shear wave and P wave velocity, and strength testing of the columns. The second test bed at the Poly site is the LORIS, or Large Outdoor Rainfall and Infiltration Simulation Facility. This facility uses a modified landfill tipper to allow for testing on slopes as steep as one horizontal to vertical. In this video, we are calibrating the special emitters designed to simulate rainfall. The green screening on the facility is to limit wind velocities for compliance with ASTM standards. Here, our technician is checking the rain gauges that were installed as part of the calibration to ensure uniform distribution of the simulated rainfall by the special emitters. The third Polytechnic site testbed is the transportable microbial nursery, developed to nurture inoculum for restoration of erosion-resistant microbial crust. The transportable nature of the facility allows us to move the facility to the project site so the inoculum can be grown in natural environmental conditions. However, our first test site was the ASU solar field, which is right next to the Poly site. ASU systems integration test beds include two local landfill sites where we are deploying our system for creating a wind erosion resistant crust using EICP. Here at the RSI landfill, we see one of our PhD students deploying the EICP solution over the monitoring grid that we set up on the site. In Beaver Dam, Wisconsin, we recently, just last week, completed construction of a test bed for our technology to remove nitrogen and phosphorus from agricultural drainage. Noteworthy on this project is a $10,000 contribution from the Fox Lake Community Association, services in kind from one of our industry partners, donated material from a former industry partner, Steel Slag, and engagement of the Wisconsin Department of Natural Resources. ASU conducted testing in the NSF NERI wave flume at Oregon State University on mitigating coastal erosion using carbonate precipitation. ASU constructed an EICP stabilized slope on the right, adjacent to an MICP stabilized slope on the left, constructed by North Carolina State and Oregon State researchers. And finally, ASU collaborated with Portland State University and NERI at UTexas on a test bed for microbial desaturation for liquefaction mitigation in Portland. Here you see the large T-Rex shaker exciting the ground above a soil stratum that was stabilized using microbial desaturation. The work attracted a lot of local media attention due to concern over liquefaction in a Cascadia subduction zone earthquake.